Welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to see a story of murder, greed, corruption, violence, exploitation, adultery, and treachery. All those things we hold near and dear to our hearts. Thank you.
All that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car. I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold, but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz. Jazz, I hear that Father Dip is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz, hold on, hon, we're gonna bunny hug. I bought some aspirin down at United Drug. In case you shake apart and want a brand new start, to do that jazz. And all that jazz. And all that jazz. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz.
Listen, your husband ain't home, is he?
No, her husband is not at home. Find a flask for playing fast and loose. And all that jazz. Right up here is where I store the juice. And all that jazz. Come on, babe, we're gonna brush the sky. I bet you lucky. Jazz. Oh, you're gonna see her, she's a shimmy shake.
Yeah, I'm afraid so, Roxy.
Oh, Fred.
Oh, Fred!
Yeah?
Nobody walks out on me!
But, sweetheart...
Oh, don't sweetheart me, you son of a bitch!
Roxy, please!
Hotcha.
Whoopee. Jazz.
I gotta pee.
So, I, took the gun, officer, and I shot him.
I see. And your wife, Roxanne, she was not involved in this affair, is that correct?
That's right, officer.
Aren't you the cheerful little murderer?
Murderer? Why, just last week, the jury thanked a man for shooting a burglar.
Well, that's just fine. Sign right here, Mr. Hart.
Freely and gladly. Freely and gladly.
For her first number, Miss Roxy Hart would like to sing a song of love and devotion dedicated to her dear husband, Amos.
Sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong, but he doesn't care, he'll string along. He loves me so. That funny honey of mine. Sometimes I'm down, sometimes I'm up, but he follows round like some droopy-eyed pup. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine.
The garage, officer, and I see him
he
coming through the window
so
with my wife, Roxanne, sleeping there like an angel. Like an angel. I mean, supposing, just supposing he violated her or something. You know what I mean. Violated.
I know what you mean.
Or something. Think how terrible that would have been. Good thing I got home from work on time, I'm telling you that. I say I'm telling you that.
Fred Casely.
Fred Casely? How could he be a burglar? My wife knows him. He sold us our furniture.
Lord knows he ain't got the smarts.
She lied to me. She told me he was a burglar.
So you're saying he was dead when you got home?
She had him covered with a sheet. She's telling me that cock and bull story about this burglar.
Now he
shot
up his
dress.
double-sided murder, Mrs. Hart. They're liable to hang you for that one.
Hang me? Oh, no. No, 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 no. Amos! Amos! Did you hear what they said? Oh, Hail Mary, full of grace!
Of the Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango.
Well, this one night, we were in Cicero, the three of us, sitting up at a hotel on the couch. such a state of shock. I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off of my hands, that I even knew they were dead! He had it coming! He had it coming! He had it coming all along! I didn't do it, but if I'd done it, how could you tell me that I was wrong?
He was a real artistic guy, sensitive, a painter, but he was troubled. He was always trying to find himself. He'd go out every night looking for himself, and on the way he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving.
I'll bet you would have done the same.
I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive. But I saw him dead!
The dirty bum, 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 bum. The dirty bum, 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 bum.
He had it come,
he had it come,
he had it come.
They had it come,
they had it come.
They had it come
all along.
Cause if they used us,
and they abused us,
and they abused
us, how could you tell us that we were wrong? He had it coming,
he had it coming.
Gentlemen, please welcome the Keeper of Keys, the Countess of Clink, the Mistress of Murderer's Row, Matron Mama Morden.
Good to Mama, and Mama was good to you. I talked to Flynn. March the 5th is when your trial is set for. March 7th, you'll be acquitted. And March 8th, do you know what Mama's gonna do for you? She's gonna put you on a vaudeville tour.
I've been on a lot of vaudeville tours, Mama. What kind of dough are we talking about?
Well, I've been talking to the boys over at William Morris, and due to your recent sensational activities, I can get you $2,500?
$2,500? The most me and Veronica ever made was $350.
That was before Cicero, before Billy Flynn, and before Mama.
Mama, I've always wanted to play Big Jim's Cosimos. Do you think you could get me that?
Big Jim's? Well, that's another story. It'd have to take another phone call.
And how much would this phone call cost?
Velma, you know how I feel about you. Only dame in this joint who's as classy as I am. You're like family. I'll do it for $50.
$50? For a phone call? You must get a lot of wrong numbers, Mama.
If you want my gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for Mama, she'll get hot for you! So what's the one conclusion I can bring this number to? When you're good to Mama, Mama's good to you.
Crime, and well, he was prepared to ask for the maximum penalty. I really would appreciate some advice.
Look,
I don't give no advice, and I don't take no advice. You're a perfect stranger to me, and I'd like to keep it that way.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Roxy, relax. In this town, murder is a form of entertainment. Besides, in 47 years, Cook County ain't never hung a woman yet. So your chances are 47 to 1.
There's always a first.
Anyways, Roxy, tell me, what do you figure on using for your grounds? What are you going to tell the jury?
Well, I figured I'd just tell them the truth.
To the wrong people.
Roxy, it's this way. Murder is like divorce. The reason don't count. It's your grounds. Self-defense, temporary insanity.
Yeah? What are your grounds?
Well, my grounds are that I didn't do it.
So then, who did?
Well, I'm sure I don't know. I blacked out completely. Only I'm sure I didn't do it. I've got the tenderest heart in the world, don't I, Mama?
You bet your ass you do, Velma.
So that's Velma Kelly.
Ain't she something? She wears nothing but black narcissist perfume and never makes her own bed. I take care of that for her.
You make her bed?
Well, not exactly. You see, it's like this. Velma gives me $5 a week, and then I give the Hungarian 50 cents, and she takes care of it. Hey, Catalan Hanyak! Sertinem ha megas merns roxy hartsons.
Not guilty!
That's all she ever says. Anyways, you know who's defending Velma, don't you?
Who?
Only Mr. Billy Flynn, best criminal lawyer in all of Chicago. That's who.
How does one get Billy Flynn?
Well, first you give me $100, and I make a phone call.
All right. How much does he get?
$5,000.
$5,000?!
I'd be more than happy to make a phone call for you, dearie.
$5,000?! Where the hell am I gonna get $5,000?
Ladies and gentlemen, a tap dance.
Oh, Amos, I knew you'd come. Look, I know I've been sinful, but I want to make it up to you for what I've done. And I will, just as soon as I get out of here. And I can, too. You see, there's this lawyer, and he calls.
Roxy, I'm tired of your fancy footwork. The answer is no.
Oh, Amos, I know I lied to you, and I know I cheated on you. I even stole money from your pants when you were sleeping.
You did?
But I never stopped loving you, not ever. I always thought, oh my, Amos, so handsome, so manly, so, oh, I'm embarrassed, sexy.
But $5,000!
It's my hour of need, for Christ's sakes!
Okay, Roxy, I'll get it for you. I'll get it. Excuse me. Hello? Hi! Hello! Oh, you, oh.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the silver-tongued prince of the courtroom, the one, the only, Mr. Billy Flynn.
Show me a long raven hair. keep your money. That's enough for me. I don't care if it's driving Packard cars, smoking long black cigars. Oh no, that's me. All I care about is doing the guy in who's picking on you, twisting the wrist that's turning the screw.
So have you got the rest of the $5,000?
Well, here's $500 on my insurance and $300 that I borrowed from the guys at the garage and $700 out of the building and loan fund.
That's $2,000.
That's all I got so far.
What about her father?
I phoned him yesterday, and he told me he'd probably be able to raise some money later.
You're a liar. I spoke to her father myself yesterday, and you want to know what he told me? That his daughter went to hell 10 years ago, and she could stay there before he'd ever spend a cent to get her out.
I'll pay you $20 a week on my salary. I'll give you notes with interest, double, triple, till every cent is paid.
You know, that's touching. But I got a motto, and that motto is this: play square, dead square. When you came to me with her case, I didn't ask you, was she guilty? I didn't ask you, was she innocent? No foolish questions like that. All I said was, have you got $5,000? And you said yes, my friend. But now you tell me you don't have $5,000, so I figure you're a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I'll keep her case because I play square. Now, by tomorrow morning, I'm going to have her on every front page as the hottest little jazz Larry since Velma Kelly. Then, we're going to hold an auction to raise money for her defense. The people will buy anything she ever owned. Dresses, shoes, underwear. And if by the due process of law she gets hanged...
Hanged?
The stuff triples in value. Let's say I give you 20% of anything I make over $5,000. Now that's what I call playing square.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
See, it's like this. Either I get the $5,000, or you will rot in jail before I ever bring you to trial. Now, here's what's going to happen. In a couple of minutes, there's going to be a big press conference here. It's going to be a whole bunch of photographers and reporters, and that sob sister from this Evening Star, Mary Sunshine, is coming. Man, is she one hell of a reporter. One hell of a lady. I mean, talk about irresistible.
When I was a tiny tot of maybe 2 or 3, I can still remember what my mother said to me. Lace rose-colored glasses on your nose, and you will see the robins not crows. For in this tent and tangled web, a weary life may weave. You're so much better of you believe.
Sunshine.
Holy crap! Mary Sunshine's gonna interview me?
Hey, and pipe down on the swearing. From here on in, you'd see nothing rougher than, oh dear! Got it? So, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna hold a big press conference, but they're not all pushovers like that Lady Sunshine. Chicago's a tough town. It's gotten so tough that they shoot the girls right down from under you. But there's one thing they can't resist, and that's a reform center. So, I've decided to rewrite the story of her life. From convent to jail. Get this. Beautiful southern home, every luxury and refinement. Parents dead, educated the Sacred Heart. A runaway marriage, a lovely, innocent girl, bewildered by what's happened. Caught up in the mad world of a great city. Jazz, cabaret, liquor. Sit down. You were drawn like a moth to a flame, a butterfly crushed under the wheel. And now the mad world has ceased. You have sinned. And you are sorry.
Well, that's just beautiful.
Now, when they ask you why you killed him, all you can remember is a fearful quarrel, and he came towards you with an awful look in his eyes. And get this, you both reached for the gun. That's your grounds. Self-defense.
Mr. Flynn, the reporters are here.
Let him in, Butch. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sunshine. You know my client, Ms. Roxy Hart.
Gentlemen, I'm just so flattered y'all came out to see little old me. I guess you want to know why I shot him, the rat.
Sit down, dummy.
Yeah.
Mr. Billy Lacey's a pet Coppins rag. He always happens his mouth never moves. Almost.
Where'd you come from?
Mississippi.
And your parents?
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under, but she was granted one more start. The Convent of the Sacred Heart.
When'd you get here?
1920.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I met Amos, and you stole my heart away. Convinced me to elope one day.
Oh, Convent, no! A runaway marriage! Oh, it's terrible! Oh, no,
dear! Who's Red Casely?
My ex-boyfriend.
Why'd you shoot him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. Still, I said, Fred, move along. She knew that she was doing wrong.
Then describe it.
He came toward me.
With a pistol.
From my bureau.
Did you fight him?
Like a tiger. He had strength and she had none. And yet we both reached for the gun. Oh, yes, we both reached for the gun.
Oh, yes, we both reached for the gun.
Understandable. Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible. Not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
How you feeling?
Very frightened.
Are you sorry?
jump the track, I'd give my life to bring him back.
And
stay away from
what?
And the liquor.
And
the men who
what?
Play for fun.
And what?
It's the thought that
yeah?
came upon me
when
we both reached for the gun.
Understandable, understandable.
Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, comprehensible. Not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
Yeah. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun, the gun, the gun, the gun. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun, for the gun.
A little louder.
Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be
got me a swell act, too. Yeah. I'll get a boy to work with. Someone who can lift me up. Oh, hell, I'll get two boys. It'll frame me better. No, Roxy. Think big. I'm gonna get me a whole bunch of boys. I, oh my gosh. The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy. The lady ringing in the chips is gonna be
Roxy. She's gonna be a celebrity.
That means somebody everyone knows.
You're gonna recognize her eyes, her hair, her teeth,
my boobs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be singing
Roxy.
Who says that murder's not an art? And who, in case she doesn't hang, can say she started with a bang? Foxy, Roxy, heart. Cha, 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 cha,
they're gonna wait outside.
Roxy, think of those autographs I'll sign. Good luck to ya, Roxy. And I'll appear in a lavalier that goes all the way down to my waist. Here a ring, there a ring, everywhere a ring-a-ling, but always in the best of taste. Ooh, I'm a star. The audience loves me for loving them, and I love the audience for loving me, and we all just love each other. And that's because we never got enough love in our childhoods.
That's right.
And that's showbiz.
Yeah.
She's given up her humdrum life.
I'm gonna be Roxy.
She made a scandal and a star.
Tour. It's canceled.
Canceled?
Well, your name hasn't been in the papers for a long time. I've been getting calls from the boys over at William Morris all day. We lost interest. We don't want her anymore. She's washed out. She's a bump. Do you know how much it hurts, Mama, to see someone she cares about like this?
Oh, sure.
All you read about today is the Heart Kid.
Hey, Mama, I've got an idea. Suppose I talk Heart into doing that sister act with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Velma Kelly in an act of desperation.
My sister and I had an act that couldn't flop. My sister and I were headed straight for the top. My sister and I are going to vow a week at least. Oh, yeah. But my sister is now, unfortunately, deceased. I know it's sad, of course, but a fact is still a fact.
same size as my sister, you'd fit in her wardrobe perfectly.
Look, why don't I show you some of the act, huh? Watch this. Now, you have to imagine it with two people. It's swell with two people. First, I... drums! Then she... saxophone! Then... together! But I can't do it alone. Then she... then I'd... then but I can't do it alone. She'd say, what's your sister like? I'd say, men, yuck, yuck, yuck. She'd say, you're the cat's meow. Then we'd wow the crowd again when she'd I Johnny's did the brow to cheer the best attraction in town. They nearly tore the balcony down. And we'd say, okay, boys, we're going home. But here's a few more party shots. And this we did in perfect unison.
Both dead! Oh, it's terrible! Trixie.
Roxy, right. Boy, what a hellion, huh? And a socialite, too. Her mother owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
Well, what do I care about pineapples? Did you get my trial date?
Yeah, I'll get to it.
Mr. Fitz!
Veronica! Velma, sorry.
There are a few things I'd like to discuss with my trial, too.
Yeah, first things first. Miss Sunshine, can I call you Mary? Do you like pineapples? let's talk pineapple. Let's talk pineapple.
Pineapples. Looks like you're in trouble now, Roxy.
Socialite. You lose again, Mama.
There's only one person who can help you now, Roxy.
There's only one person you can count on now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart and Miss Velma Kelly sing a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
examiner. She said she's gonna have a baby.
Why did I do that?
Please, ladies and gentlemen of the press, leave the two of us alone so we can rest.
The two of us?
Can you imagine? I mean, can you imagine?
Can I have one last picture, please?
Oh, sure. Anything for the press.
Do you believe it? I mean, do you believe it?
My dear.
Consequential, me. Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there.
Well, hello, Andy. I didn't see you there.
Amos! My name is Amos!
Who said it wasn't? It's the kid's name I'm thinking about.
What kid?
Roxy's kid? You know when she's due? Early fall. September. September. That means you couldn't possibly be. But I want you to pass out those cigars anyway. I don't want you to care when people laugh.
Laugh? Why would they laugh?
Because they can count. Can you count? Early fall. September! September? That means you couldn't possibly. But my client needs your support.
But we hadn't copulated for 4 months prior to the incident. That means I couldn't possibly be.
Divorce her? My God, man! You divorce her with such a little thing like that? What is wrong with you?
You're damned right. That's what I'll do. I'll divorce her. She probably won't even notice.
You still here, Andy? I thought you'd gone.
Yes, I'm still here. I think.
Should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell ya, cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. Never even know I'm there.
Hope I didn't take up too much of your time.
Hey, Butch, get Roxy for me, will you?
Flynn, glad to see you. Look, March 5th is only a few weeks away, and I've been making plans. Look, silver shoes with rhinestone buckles.
Look, kid, your trial date's been set back.
Oh, no.
Well, it's a couple of weeks, I promise.
And who got my date? As if I didn't know. Roxy Hart?
Look, there's a lot of pressure on me. The girl's having a baby.
Tell me about it. Listen, Flynn, I figure if I'm sensational in court, I could get things moving again. I've been thinking a lot about my trial. Could I at least show you what I might do on the witness stand?
Go ahead.
Hit it! Well, when I got on the stand, I thought I'd take a peek at the jury, and then I'd cross my legs like this.
When Velma takes the stand,
embarrassed and cross-examines me, I thought I'd give him this. And then if he yells at me, I thought I'd tremble like this. Oh no, please stop!
When Velma takes the stand, look at little Vel. See her, give him hell. Ain't she doing grand? She's gotta be out of the palm of her hands.
Then I thought I'd let it all be too much for me, like real dramatic. Then I thought I'd get thirsty and say, please, someone, can I have a glass of water?
When Velma takes a stand, see that Kelly girl make that jury whirl. When she turns it on, she's gonna get going, she's got a gun.
Then I thought I'd cry. Buckets. Only I don't have a handkerchief. That's what I have to ask you for yours. I really like that part, don't you? Then I get up, only I'm too weak. So I slump, and I slump, and I slump, and I slump, and I slump, until finally I faint.
When she rolls her eyes, then she takes a prize. When Velma takes a stand.
To file you for divorce.
Yeah? So now what?
So now, when Amos takes a stand, I'll get him to admit he still loves you and you made a terrible mistake, and you'll admit you still love him, and now the jury's gonna be playing Cupid trying to get you two back together. Smart, huh?
Smart, huh?
And another thing.
And another thing!
When Amos is on the stand, I want you to be knitting a baby garment.
I don't know how to knit!
Then learn!
Look, I am sick and tired of everybody treating me like I'm just some dumb common criminal.
But you are just some dumb common criminal?
Well, that's better than being a greasy lawyer. After all, he can steal.
Oh, maybe go in court without me, huh? See how that goes for you.
You know, maybe I will. I'm a star. They love me.
You're a funny celebrity, kid. In a couple of weeks, no one will even know who you are. That's Chicago.
No! No! No!
No. Ladies and gentlemen, for your pleasure and your entertainment, give you Catalin on that and her Hungarian rope trick.
Not guilty. Not guilty. Not guilty.
Shattered. Catlin Hunyak has been hung tonight for the murder of her ex-husband. The Hungarian woman's last words were, not guilty.
sorry. I'll do anything you say.
So now you're clear about what you're going to do on the stand?
I've been practicing all night.
You ready?
Billy, I'm scared.
You got nothing to worry about, kid. It's all a circus. A three-ring circus. These trials, the whole world, all show business. But kid, you're working with a star. The biggest. Give 'em the old razzle dazzle 'em. Give 'em a net with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give 'em the old hocus pocus, fool and feather 'em. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if your hinges are all rusting? What if, in fact, you're just disgusting? Razzle dazzle 'em, and they'll never catch wise. Give 'em the old razzle dazzle 'em. Give 'em a show that's so splendiferous. Row after row, well, row vociferous.
Give 'em the old three-ring circus, fool and fracture 'em.
How can they hear the truth above the roar?
Throw on a fake and a finagle, they'll never know you're just
a bagel. Razzle dazzle 'em,
and they'll beg you for more.
Since the days of old Methuselah,
everyone loves a big Methuselah. Give 'em the old three-ring circus, stun and stagger 'em. When you're in trouble, go into your dance. No, you are safer than a girder.
Razzle dazzle 'em,
and you've got a romance. Give 'em the old razzle dazzle 'em.
Give 'em an act that's unassailable. They'll wait a year till you're available.
Give 'em the old double.
First-rate sorcerer you are.
Long as you keep them way off balance, how can they spot you've got no talents?
Razzle dazzle 'em,
razzle dazzle 'em,
razzle dazzle 'em, and they'll make you a star.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present Justice.
State of Illinois versus Roxy Hart for the murder of Fred Casely. Thank you. The state calls Mr. Amos Hart.
Blah, 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 blah. Truth, 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 so help you God.
I certainly do.
Question by Sergeant Fogarty. What happened next? Answer by Roxy Hart. I shot him because he was walking out on me with the louse. Signed, Roxy Hart. Do you recognize the signature?
Yes, sir. It's the signature of the lady who used to be my wife.
Exactly. Take the witness.
Hello, Amos.
Amos, that's right, Mr. Flynn, Amos.
You are, at present, obtaining a divorce from the defendant. Any reason?
I'll say. The newspaper said that she was expecting a little stranger.
So, it's on the grounds for a divorce, is it?
A little too much of a stranger.
So what you're saying is you doubted the paternity of the child?
Well, sure.
But did you even bother to ask her if you were the father?
No, sir, but you told
me— Just jump to a conclusion? Is that what you call playing square? If Roxy Hart swore that you were the father of her child, which she does.
She does?
I do!
She does! Sit down, Daddy. The defense calls Ms. Roxy Hart.
Roxy Hart to the stand!
Blah, 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 truth, 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 so help you God.
I certainly do.
Ooh. Ah.
Oh. What's your name?
Roxy.
Roxy, I have here a statement in which you admit to having illicit affairs with the deceased Fred Casely. Is this statement true or false?
Oh, I'm afraid that's true.
Yet you were married, Mrs. Hart.
I know. And I don't think I would have gone with him if me and Mr. Hart had quarreled that very morning.
Quarreled? About what?
Oh, Amos, I don't want to work at that seedy Southside nightclub.
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't like you working those long hours at the garage either.
Sure, sure.
Oh, Amos, I want a real home and a child.
Fat chance.
So you entered this illicit relationship with Casely because you were unhappy at home.
Oh, most unhappy.
Yet you respect the sacredness of the marriage vow.
Oh, yes, sir.
Then why didn't you stop this affair with Mr. Casely?
Well, I tried, but Mr. Casely, he'd plead, he'd say,
I can't live without you! I can't live without you! I can't live without you!
Roxy, the state of Illinois has accused you of the murder of Mr. Fred Casely. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Oh, not guilty! Not guilty! I killed him, yes. But I'm not a criminal!
There, there. There, there. Roxy, can you recall the night of February the 14th?
Yes, sir.
Then please, in your own way, tell the jury the happenings of that night.
Well, it was after work, about 2 in the morning, and I'd stopped at an all-night grocery store to get baking soda to make cupcakes for my Amos. Oh, Amos just loved my cupcakes. And then I went straight home. I was getting ready for bed when suddenly the doorbell rang.
When you're in trouble,
ding dong.
Well, I thought it was my girlfriend Gloria, so I slipped on my kimono and I went to the door.
And who was there?
Fred Casely!
And what did he say?
That letter you wrote me, telling me it was all over. Why did you write it?
Because I have seen the error of my ways.
And what did you say?
I said, go away!
Beat it, buddy!
I tried to close the door, but he forced his way in. I ran to the bedroom, but he followed me. Please, no good will come of this. And besides, I love my husband.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
So you told him you loved your husband. And what happened next?
I don't care. You're mine. You're mine. You're mine.
You must tell the jury everything. They have a right to know.
All right. Me and Amos, we're gonna have a baby.
And what did he say to that?
I'll kill you before I see you have another man's child.
And what happened next?
In his passion, he ripped off my kimono and threw me across the room. Mr. Hart's revolver was laying there between us. He grabbed for the gun.
And then?
I knocked it from his hands. He whirled me aside.
And then?
And then we both reached for the gun. But I got it first.
Hooray!
Then he started coming at me with this funny look in his eyes.
I mean to kill you.
So you're saying he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes, sir.
So it's his life or yours?
And not just mine. So I closed my eyes, and I shot.
Roxy! Roxy, please!
In defense of your life!
Dazzle, dazzle,
dazzle, to save my husband's unborn child!
And I'll make you a star!
Mrs. Hart's behavior during this whole ordeal has been truly extraordinary.
I bet it has.
Seated next to her attorney, Mr. Billy Flynn, oh, she weeps. She fishes in her handbag, but cannot seem to find a handkerchief.
Handkerchief?
Finally, her attorney, Mr. Billy Flynn, hands her one.
That's my bit.
Mrs. Hart, her usual gracious self, thanks the bailiff, and he smiles at her. She looks simply radiant in her elegant blue dress and silver shoes.
The rhinestone buckles?
What rhinestone buckles?
Velma, take it easy.
Those are my shoes.
Well, you shouldn't have left them laying around.
Ladies and gentlemen, a hush has fallen over the courtroom as Mr. Billy Flynn prepares his summation to the jury. The next voice that you will hear will be that of Mr. Billy Flynn, champion of the downtrodden.
Ladies and gentlemen, you and I have never killed. We can't possibly know the agony, the hell that Roxy Hart went through that night. This drunken beast, Fred Casely, forced his way into her home, forced liquor upon her, physically abused her, and threatened her life. At that moment, motherly love and a deep sense of security for her neighbor's safety stirred within her. She shot him. We don't deny that. But God, hasn't she been through enough? She has prayed to God for forgiveness for what she has done, and she is sorry. You may take her life, yes, but it won't bring Casely back. Just look. Look at that frail figure. She's been through so much. Don't you want to just let her be free? We may not be able to give Roxy Hart happiness, but what we can give her is a second chance. The defense rests.
Members of the jury, how have you reached your verdict?
We have, Your Honor!
Will the defendant please rise? And what is your verdict?
We find the defendant!
You should see what's going on out there. There was this divorce action, and this babe shot her husband, his mother, and the defense attorney. It's awful. There's blood all over the walls.
guilty?
Well, who cares about that?
I saved your life.
Yeah, but where are all the photographers, the reporters, the publicity? I was counting on that.
You know, your gratitude is overwhelming, really. But I'm only in it for the money anyway.
Yeah, you get $5,000 and I wind up with nothing.
You're a free woman, Roxy Hart. And God save Illinois. My asking music, please!
All I care about is love!
Roxy?
Oh, what the hell do you want?
I'd like you to come home. You said you still wanted me, and I still love you. And the baby, our baby.
Baby? There ain't no baby.
There ain't no baby?
That's right.
Roxy! I still love you.
They didn't want my picture. I don't understand that. They didn't even want my picture.
May I have my exit music, please? Okay.
Gone. All gone. And that's good, isn't it? Grand, isn't it? Great, isn't it? Swell, isn't it? Fun, isn't it? Now
lot of people have lost faith in America.
And for what America stands for.
But we are the living examples of what a wonderful country this is.
So we'd just like to say thank you. And God bless you.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
At 5 p.m. So spread the word if you like the show, and thank you for your patronage.